Okay, so I'm here with Christian Deneff, who spoke yesterday on innovation. And Chris, I just wanted to have you share some of the takeaways from your presentation. First, could you just talk about the different types of innovation that you kind of reviewed with the audience and how that changes and has evolved?
Yeah, sure. If we go back a number of years, I mean, the focus was essentially on product innovation. And what we've seen is that we've been moving away from product innovation. I mean, it's still extremely important, but we've been moving away from product innovation into other sorts of innovation. So the first step of this was into process innovation, which is really like improving the way the product is being designed and produced and so forth and so forth. And the next step has been business model innovation, which is really looking at beyond the product, beyond the service, how are we going to, you know, monetize this? How are we going to deal with our clients when it's actually this potentially changing to our business model? But what we've seen with things like Blue Ocean Strategy and those types of books recently is that we actually go into new markets. We go into markets where the competition can't go. And so we're actually innovating markets. We're creating new markets. And certainly there's going to be a next evolution, but we don't know what that is yet.
You know, some of the other things you talked about as far as the evolution of product development, you talked about social computing and just the social aspects in the different phases of product development. Can you just speak to that? What were you trying to get at in that part of your presentation?
I think that's all related to the notion of open innovation. I mean, the traditional innovation was basically an organization was using its internal resources and was developing new products with its own R&D people, often a department somewhere in a corner. R&D has moved from there to the whole organization and then has moved across the borders of the organization in the outside world. And as it has moved in the outside world, there's been an opportunity to use social media in the innovation cycle. So when you're in search of a good idea, I mean, why wouldn't you ask to the outside world? Why wouldn't you do some crowdsourcing for ideas? Why wouldn't you just test some ideas and see how people react? If you're actually in the design phase, why wouldn't you actually crowdsource your design, or why wouldn't you do co-creation with your clients? Or sometimes actually at the other end of the value chain, why would you do it with your suppliers? If you need to go to ramping up production, you could actually do co-production. And you could do actually testing in the social space. There's companies like Nokia. If you're a member of their, forgot the name of their social media efforts, you will get phones, you know, weeks or months before other people get them. And you will blog about it, you will do a number of things in the social area. And then, of course, when you are into product launch, and we all know that, you use social media to create an incredible buzz about your product. So we see that social media, because of this opening up to the outside world, because of open innovation, is actually now a place in every cycle of the innovation cycle.
So speaking of that co-creation, you shared several interesting examples with the audience of two very different products, two different maybe even companies and cultures, but coming together to produce something innovative that maybe solved a similar problem. Can you share a couple of those examples?
Yeah, the key idea behind that is that we not only open up from inside our company to the outside world, but we also need to open up from our current practice or our current industry to potentially applying elements or technologies which are from other industries or sometimes even from other disciplines of science. Because the solution to our problem very often has already been found or has already been developed elsewhere, and we could apply it in our environment. And so a couple of the examples that I gave yesterday, you have Kraft cheese, which has this challenge of having to slice cheese, which is, you know, not an easy thing because, you know, it's whatever. It's not easy to deal with. And you have Goodyear tires, and they actually have a similar problem. Of course, cheese and tires are not the same. Naturally, they would never have met if they wouldn't have done the effort of going outside their industry and trying to see if there was parallels that could be found in other industries. And what we see today is that medical technologies enter in the automotive industry. Automotive technologies may enter into agriculture. And there is this really potential of using solutions which have been developed in one industry and applying them in other industries, which is entirely new.
Okay, great. Thanks, Christian.
Great pleasure.